El Shaddai, El Elyon Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same by the power of the name. El Shaddai, Echam Kana Adonai. We will praise and lift you high, El Shaddai. Through your love and through the ram, you saved the son of Abraham. Through the power of your hand, turn the sea into dry land. To the outcast on her knees, you were the God who really sees. And by your might, you set your children. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Elyon Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same by the power of the name. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, Echam Kana Adonai. We will praise and lift you high, El Shaddai. Though the people couldn't see what Messiah ought to be, though your word contained the plan, they just could not understand. Your most awesome work was done through the frailty of your son. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Elyon Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same by the power of the name. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, Echam Kana Adonai. I will praise you till I die, El Shaddai.
Church in Green Valley, and today is the 22nd of July. I know that so well because it's my mom's birthday, and today is a Wednesday. Being that it's Wednesday, it's Wacky Wednesday, Noah couldn't be here with us, but a friend of his stopped in, right, Noah's friend? And he's got some riddles for us. What do you got?
What can travel all around the world without leaving its corner?
Something that doesn't leave its corner, it goes all around the world. I mean, if I'm on a corner, I have to go down this sidewalk or that sidewalk. I don't know.
A stamp.
Oh, a stamp on the corner of an envelope. You're being tricky today. All right, anything else?
What building has the most stories?
Building has the most stories. Well, the Empire State Building had a lot of stories, 102 stories. A long time ago is that tallest building. I don't know what the tallest building is. I don't know.
The library.
The library has the most stories. Well, thank you, Noah's friend. And we're back. I would like to preface our prayer for today with a quote. I have been driven many times upon my knees by the overwhelming conviction that I had nowhere else to go. My own wisdom and that of all about me seemed insufficient for that day. And that quote is from Abraham Lincoln, who was very wise, but was wise enough to know that he was weak and needed help. And when we are in times of need, we turn to God. Please pray with me. Lord, remind us always that we stand in your need. Without you, we are so weak. With you, we are made strong. Guide us always according to your wishes. Amen. Our scripture today is from the book of Matthew, the 12th chapter. It begins with the 15th verse. Jesus, knowing they were out to get him, moved on. A lot of people followed him, and he healed them all. He also cautioned them to keep it quiet, following guidelines set down by Isaiah. Look well at my hand-picked servant. I love him so much. Take such delight in him. I placed my spirit on him. He'll decree justice to the nations. But he won't yell, won't raise his voice. There'll be no commotion in the streets. He won't walk over anyone's feelings, won't push you into a corner. Before you know it, his justice will triumph. The mere sound of his name will signal hope, even among far-off believers. Here ends our gospel reading. And I think what's an important part of this reading, Jesus does it again. He does this throughout Scripture, during his ministry, where he will talk to people, he will heal them, and all of a sudden they'll say, but keep quiet about this. And of course, when something miraculous takes place, when something wonderful takes place, you don't want to hide it. You don't want to keep it a secret. You want to share it with your friends. You want to say, guess what I found out? Guess what I saw? Guess what I heard? Listen to this wonderful news. That's how we're wired inside. That's just how we are built. That's our makeup. We want to share the good news. And yet Jesus says, keep it quiet. And he had a reason for that. He had his own timeline. Jesus, according to the revealing of his purpose on earth, it was according to the Father's guideline, according to his calendar. Jesus says, keep it quiet. It's not the right time. But the time came when the time was proper. The time came when Jesus knew it was the right time and that the cross was near. Remember always that there is no time like the present. No time like the present for us to share God's love, to share his gospel. Jesus has gone to the cross. Jesus has risen victorious from the empty tomb. And we have been given that great news to share whenever possible. Amen. As we close, we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord Jesus abide with you now and always. Amen.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet. Be near.